I have the privilege to introduce our founding lord, a great general. Sir, you are welcome, sir. We are grateful to have you in our midst. Thank you, sir.
Praise the Lord. Niger State, Power State, I said, praise the Lord. The rain of miracle is going to fall tonight. Supernatural rain. If you are expecting your rain of miracle, where are you? Can you raise up your hand? It's coming. A rain of salvation. A rain of healing. The rain of deliverance is coming upon your life right now. Keep up that hand. We're going to pray. Heavenly Father, we thank you today. We thank you for the people of Niger State. Thank you because of the power that is going to come upon everybody today. Lord, I pray tonight, you will roll away every mountain in Jesus' name. Supernatural rain for all. Supernatural salvation for all. Supernatural healing for all. Supernatural deliverance for all. I pray tonight the heavens will be opened. And you bless everyone. And nobody will go away empty-handed. Fulfill the expectation of your people. I thank you because I know it's done. Fill every heart with joy. In Jesus' name I pray. God bless you. You can sit down. It's a great pleasure to be with you in Niger State. And I believe that we're expecting something great from the Lord. You will not be disappointed in Jesus' name. I'm reading a story to you from 1 Kings chapter 18. Because we're expecting supernatural rain. It's not the ordinary rain. It's greater, it's higher, it's bigger, and it's more enriching than the natural rain. And as the rain comes from heaven, the power of God is coming from heaven. Your miracle is coming from heaven. I was thinking Niger State will give me a good Niger State. Amen. I'm looking at 1 Kings chapter 18. And I read from verse 41. And Elijah said unto Ahab, get thee up, eat and drink. For there is a sound of abundance of rain. I need to tell you the story. After many years of suffering, after many years of sickness, after many years of agony, here comes the man of God. Here comes the prophet of God. And Elijah came to all the people and said, how long hold ye between two opinions? How long are you here or there? How long will you dilly-dally and you are going up and down? Where is your mind? Where is your faith? Where is your hope? Where is your expectation? How long halt ye between two opinions? If the Lord be God, follow him. But ye Baal, then follow him. And the people answered him not a word. They didn't know what to do. They didn't know what to say. You are there tonight. There's confusion in your life. The problem has been for a long time. Suffering for a long time. Today, the rain of heaven will come upon your life. You have been in darkness for a long time. Those blind eyes will open tonight. You are paralyzed and you are helpless. You are hopeless. But hope has come tonight. Help has come tonight. Miracle has come tonight. And you are going to have the miracle in Jesus' name. As we begin to pray, the power of God will come from heaven. That power will touch your life. That power will roll the mountains away. The Lord will set you free. What is the one I'm talking about there? The Lord will set you free. He will change everything changeable in your life. Everything to shake out of your life, he'll shake it out tonight. That madness will vanish away. Evil spirit will vanish away. The power of the Lord is coming your way. After Elijah had repaired the altar of the Lord, then he came to Ahab and he said in verse 41, get thee up, eat and drink, banish sorrow from your life. Tonight your problem is solved. Take all the confusion away. Tonight your miracle has come. Eat and drink, for there is a sound of abundance of rain. Tonight I'm going to look at the scriptures briefly. I'm talking to you on the great day of supernatural rain. This is a day you will never forget. Unforgettable. Always will be remembered. The day when God opened your blind eyes, you will not forget. The day when God sent his power on your life and the lame man rose up and began to walk. The day when God takes the hunchback away from you, you will not forget today. That goiter in your neck, the day when God takes the goiter away, you'll not forget today. Long time pregnancy, you've been pregnant for a long time and you have not delivered. The day when God brought deliverance to you, you will not forget today. Sickness will vanish away. Suffering will vanish away. They told me Niger State has power. Say, give me a powerful amen. The great day of supernatural rain. There are three things we're looking at. Number one, the promise. Number two, the period. Number three, your portion. I will have my portion. Somebody there, I will have my portion. Somebody there, I will have my portion of miracle. Number one, the promise of supernatural rain. You see, everything you're looking for, the peace of mind you're asking for, and the joy of the Lord you're looking for, and the prosperity you're looking for, and all the joy that will come to your life, the Lord has given us a promise that cannot fail. He puts that promise under the name of rain. And he says that rain will come to you. You want to be great? It's a kind of rain. You want to be prospered? It's a kind of rain. You want miracle? It's a kind of rain. If you look at Deuteronomy chapter 28, verses 12 and 13. Deuteronomy chapter 28, verse 12. The Lord shall open unto thee his good treasure, Looks like half of the people are saying amen. God loves you. God is thinking about you. He knows your tears. He knows your sorrow. And thank God tonight, the day of sorrow has gone. That's why it says in verse 12, the Lord shall open unto thee his good treasure. Listen to this, the heaven to give the rain unto thy land in its season. And then what will happen after the rain has come? And to bless all the work of thine hand. The curse is cancelled from your life. Evil is taken away from your life. All that premature death in your family is cancelled tonight. Because the Lord is going to open the heavens unto you. And is going to give you the rain in his season. And to bless all the work of your hands. Look at this one. And thou shalt lend unto many nations, and thou shalt not borrow. These days of recession, you'll be prospered. Poverty cancelled from your life. Suffering cancelled from your life. Sorrow cancelled from your life. Sickness cancelled from your life. Look at verse 13. What follows the rain that fell in verse 12? The Lord shall make thee the head, and not the tail. The Lord shall promote you. And all the things that brought you down, everything will be cut off from your life. He will bless your family. He will bless your business. He will bless your life. That's what it says. It says the Lord shall make thee the head and not the tail. And thou shalt be above only. Thou shalt be above only. This is a day that will change your life. A day that will take sorrow, suffering away from your life. Somebody there, you'll be thinking of, you're fed up, you're tired, you want to commit suicide. Better days are starting today. But you know what it says over here? It says, and thou shalt not be beneath. If that thou hearken unto the commandment of the Lord thy God, which I command thee this day to observe and to do them. It's the promise of supernatural rain. The promise of salvation. Tonight, he will save you. He will forgive your sin. He will take that evil habit away from you. That captivity to Satan, he will take away. That captivity to bad habit and bad life, he will take away from you. This one in Joel chapter 2. Joel chapter 2. We're talking about the promise of supernatural rain. Joel chapter 2, I'm reading from verse 23. Be glad then, ye children of Zion. Rejoice in the Lord your God. For he has given you the former rain moderately. He says, rejoice. Let all that sadness be wiped away from your life. A great new door is opening before you. A door into the blessing of God. A door into the power that will break every yoke in your life. That's why he said, rise up and rejoice. Then he said, he has given you the former rain moderately. What does that mean? It means the testimonies you heard before. How the Lord touched somebody who had been paralyzed, and then he got up, and now he can jump, he can run. He says, that's moderate miracle. How God made somebody who had been, you know, she was expecting operation before delivery, but the Lord touched her, and then everything was rolled away, and she delivered normally. God said, that's the former miracle, former rain. Something greater is coming your way. But he said, that's a former rain. Look at that verse 23. And he will cause to come down for you the rain. The former rain and the latter rain in his first month. Something good is coming. Verse 25. And I will restore to you the years that the locusts have eaten. That's the supernatural rain we're talking about. Every good thing you have ever lost in your life, mark the word of God now, is coming back to your life. It says the years that the locusts have eaten and the canker worm and the caterpillar and the palmer worm, my great army which I sent among you. And look at verse 26. And ye shall eat in plenty and be satisfied, and praise the name of the Lord your God that has dealt wondrously with you. And my people shall never be ashamed. Somebody there, my people shall not be ashamed. Shame is going away from your life tonight. Reproach is going away from your life tonight. It's a new day. It's a new dawn. Because the supernatural rain is going to fall. And as you come to the Lord, I say, Lord, I am here. Let the rain fall. Let the miracle come. Let your power flow. Let it touch me. Let it turn my life around. Tonight, you are a candidate for miracle. And then it says in verse 28, and it shall come to pass afterward that I will pour out of my spirit upon all flesh. Upon all flesh. Upon all flesh. Somebody there today, I congratulate you. You will not go empty handed. And your sons and your daughters shall prophesy. Your old men shall dream dreams. And your young men shall see visions. Also upon my servants and upon my handmaids in those days, I will pour out my spirit. You can tell, number one, the promise of supernatural rain before this time that the man of God in the Bible is talking about. Before this time that the prophet came to the people of God, there was a period of no supernatural rain. That leads me to point number two. The period of no supernatural rain. Maybe you've gone through that period in your life. It's a wilderness life. It's a life in the desert. It's a life of need. It's a life of dryness. It's a life of poverty. It's a life of suffering. It's a life of sickness. The period of no supernatural rain. And the Lord told them why. Why there was no rain. As we are preparing for the rain to come. As we are preparing for the miracle to come. You must understand. Why do people go through the period of no supernatural rain? Deuteronomy chapter 11. I'm reading here from verse 16. Deuteronomy chapter 11 verse 16. It says, take heed to yourselves that your heart be not deceived. And ye turn aside and serve other gods and worship them. Then the Lord's wrath be kindled against you. And he shut up the heavens that there be no rain. He shut up the heaven that there be no rain. God says our life depends on the rain. Our fruit of the land depends upon the rain. The freshness of the forest and the freshness of the city depends upon the rain. Freshness of life. Fruitfulness in life. Everything depends upon the rain from heaven. The overflowing joy and provision of God's people. Everything depends upon the rain from heaven. And he says, when the people of God, when they go astray, when they worship other gods, then the Lord's wrath will come. Our sins make God angry against us. He says, I created you, and I created the ground on which you are walking. When you build your house, I created that. You are my tenant. You are my creature. And you are occupying the land. You are not paying your due. You are not paying your rent. Your rent of just loving me. I'm not asking for your money. I'm asking for your love. I'm asking for your appreciation. I'm asking for your obedience. And you didn't pay your rent for many years. You owe me that love. You owe me that obedience. You owe me that honor and respect. And now because I called you, you will not answer me. Then he shuts up the heavens and there's no rain. What's God saying? Is God saying then there'll be no rain ever? No, see, no, come back and tell me you are sorry. I am sorry I didn't pay my rent. I am sorry I didn't love you. I am sorry I didn't obey you. And then tonight something will change. I said tonight something will change. The heavens will be opened. And the rain will begin to fall again. I said the rain will begin to fall again. What will happen? If tonight you say, God, I see my error, I sense my fault, I see where I've gone astray, I come back to show love to you, I come back, I believe on the Lord Jesus Christ, I come back, I hold on to Jesus as my Savior. Look at verse 21. Then your days will be multiplied. I thought God's people will say amen. Your days may be multiplied, and the days of your children in the land which the Lord swore unto your fathers to give them. Look at the last line. The last line, that this is wonderful. Wonder of all wonders today. Wonders upon your life. Wonders in your family. Wonders upon your business. Wonders on your life. As the days of heaven on the earth. You didn't hear that one. As the days of heaven upon the earth. God said angels are not in poverty or need or sickness as they are in heaven upon the earth. He'll give you the days of heaven upon the
earth.
There was no rain because of our sin. But now when we turn away from our sin, I will say, Lord, I understand. And the cause of my problem, because the soul that sinneth, it shall die. Now I come back to the Lord. Something will turn around. Your life will turn around. And that rain will fall tonight. I said that rain will fall tonight. In 1 Kings chapter 8. 1 Kings chapter 8, verse 35, it says, when heaven is shut up and there is no rain. You see that? There's a period of no rain. I'm sure you've seen that period in your life. When heaven is shut up and you prayed and there was no answer. Heaven was shut up. You fasted and there was no answer. Heaven was shut up. You say, God, look at me. Look at my condition. And there was no answer. Look at this. When heaven is shut up and there is no rain, because they have sinned against thee. No rain because they have sinned against thee. That's why, as we're expecting the rain of miracle to fall tonight, we turn away from our sin and heaven will smile at you. The favor of God will come upon you. The forgiveness of God will come to you. And the blessings of heaven will come upon you. It says, if they pray toward this place and confess thy name and turn from their sin, when thou afflictest them, then hear thou in heaven and forgive the sin of thy servants and of thy people, that thou teach them the good way wherein they should walk, and give rain upon the land. It says, if there is no rain and we feel dry, we feel tired, we feel sick, incurable disease, then we realize why there was no rain, and we come to God and we repent. He says then everything will turn around. In your life tonight, I'm talking to somebody there. I said, in your life tonight, I'm talking to one man, one woman there. In your life tonight, I'm talking to that sick person there tonight. Heaven will smile at you. The favor of God will come upon you, because I have realized why there was no rain. And now the rain will begin to fall. Somebody there is getting ready. Somebody there is getting ready. Your life will be happy. Your life will be blessed. Look at this. 2 Chronicles chapter 7. 2 Chronicles chapter 7. I'm reading from verse 13. Verse 13 says, look at this. The period of no rain. You understand why there's no rain? Why there's no supernatural rain? again. What is no miracle? What is no healing? What is no deliverance? Look at this. If I shut up heaven, that there be no rain. Or if I command the locusts to devour the land. Or if I send pestilence among my people. It says, when you see there is no rain, oh, it's not the time. Okay, I will not go to church anymore. I will not worship God anymore. Because look at it, I am poor. Look at it, I am sick. Look at it, I'm oppressed. Look at it, I failed my exam. Look at it, I don't have any job. All you're saying is there's no rain. The period of no supernatural rain. If I shut up heaven, that there be no rain. Or if I command the locusts to devour the land. Or if I send pestilence among my people. Look at verse 14. If my people which are called by my name shall humble themselves and pray and seek my face and turn from their wicked ways. That's what we are going to do tonight. I said that's what we are going to do tonight. Because the key is in your hand. And some people say, well, when God wants, He will send the rain. They say, it's God that decides. God says, no, I throw the ball in your court. If there's a period of no rain, and you realize you want supernatural rain, if my people who are called by my name, if they will humble themselves and pray and seek my face and turn from their wicked ways, He says, then I will hear from heaven. I will forgive their sin. He will forgive you tonight. What are you there? Forgiveness is coming to you tonight. What are you there? The favor of God is coming to you tonight. I will forgive their sins. No matter what you have done, no matter what you have said, no matter the guilt and the condemnation, no matter the terrible thing you have done, God says, just turn, just repent. I will forgive their sin. And I will heal their land. Somebody there is getting healed today. I said, somebody there is getting healed today. Number one is the promise. Number two is a period. The period of no supernatural rain. Number three now, your portion of supernatural rain. I said you have a portion to claim, a portion to receive, a portion to enjoy. You know what? When the rain is falling, you know, you cannot say, well, I'm not a white man, so I cannot go in the rain and fetch my water. You cannot say, I'm not educated, therefore I cannot get my portion of the rain. You cannot say, I'm not a strong man, I cannot go and get my portion of rain. The rain falling tonight is for everyone. Supernatural rain for all. Your portion is available. Whatever your problem, whatever your sickness, congratulations. I rejoice with you. Tonight is your night of salvation. Tonight is the night of your freedom. Tonight is the night of your miracle. Your portion of supernatural rain. Your portion. Say, my portion. I said, my portion. Are you there? Are you getting ready? Are you going to have your miracle tonight? Of course, of course. Are you going to have forgiveness tonight? Of course. Are you going to have the peace of God tonight? Of course, it's part of the rain. And as the rain is going to fall, I say, Lord, I am here. That supernatural rain is for me. Your portion of supernatural rain. Your portion of supernatural rain. Look at Hosea chapter 10. Hosea chapter 10. Here I'm reading from verse 12. It says, sow to yourselves in righteousness and reap in mercy. Break up your fallow ground. For it is time to seek the Lord till he come and rain righteousness upon you. We've been going in the wrong direction. And so we met a roadblock. A roadblock to prosperity. A roadblock to joy. And then the Lord is saying, look at what is happening to you. You have seen, you have suffering. You have seen, you have sickness. You have seen, you have sorrow. And you have seen and the scarcity in your life. He says, now sow to yourself in righteousness. Come back, come back. There's no way, there's no way there. Drunkenness, there's no way there. All that fighting, smoking, there's no way there. All that wickedness, there's no way there. He says, come back, suit yourself in righteousness. And say, tonight I come back to my God. Tonight I come back to my God. Suit yourself in righteousness. Reap in mercy. Mercy is waiting for you tonight. You will come into the mercy of God. Where are you there? For God so loved you that he gave his only begotten son, that whosoever believeth, as you believe on the Lord Jesus Christ tonight, you will not perish. Say amen for yourself.
Amen.
You will not perish. You will have everlasting life. For it is time to seek the Lord until he comes and he rains righteousness upon you. Ezekiel chapter 34. Look at verse 26. The Lord loves you. God loves you. The Savior loves you. The healer loves you. The deliverer loves you. See what he has promised for you. And I will make them and the places round about my hill a blessing. Curse is cancelled from your life tonight. And I will cause the shower to come down in a season. Look at that verse 26. There shall be showers of blessing. To the left over there, to my frontier, to the right over there, to the back, there shall be showers of blessing. The rain is going to begin to fall right now. There'll be showers of salvation. There'll be showers of healing. There'll be showers of deliverance. There'll be showers of miracle. And the rain is for everyone. The rain is for everyone. It's for me. I said it's for me. I said it's for me. Say it for yourself. I say it's for me. Forgiveness is for everyone. Peace of mind is for everyone. What Jesus did on the cross of Calvary is for everyone. Whatever you have done, you can say, Lord, I come today. I want my portion of supernatural rain. My portion of supernatural rain. How many are going to have their own portion? I said, how many are going to have their own portion? Wonderful. Wonderful. The Lord will satisfy you. Satisfy you with salvation. Satisfy you with miracle. Rain is going to fall. The rain is going to fall. Are you ready? Heads bowed and eyes closed. Heads bowed and eyes closed. The Lord is looking at you right now. You know, when there was no rain, no joy, no peace, no refreshing, no power, no strength. You know why there is suffering, and why there was no supernatural rain? Because of your sin. And the Lord is saying that you will turn away from that sin. You say, Lord, please forgive me. If my people who are called by my name, if they will humble themselves, if they will seek my face, if they will pray, if they will turn from their wicked ways, I will hear from heaven. I will forgive their sin. I will heal their land. And supernatural rain will come for you. It's bowed and eyes closed. If you want that forgiveness, if you want that salvation, if you want the favor of the Lord today, and say, Lord, I want eternal life. I want salvation today. I want you to forgive my sins and get me ready for the rain. Wherever you are, you raise up your hand. You say, Lord, I am here. I want that forgiveness. Lord, I am here. I want that salvation. I know I've sinned against you. I'm turning away from my sin. Wherever you are, you raise up your hand. Say, Lord, I am here. I am sorry for the sin I committed. Forgive me. Forgive me. If you are saying that, you raise up your hand. If you are raising up your hand, you will stand up. You say, Lord, I am here today for that supernatural rain. Wherever you are, you want forgiveness. You raise up your hand, and then you stand up. You say, Lord, pour that rain upon me. Pour that rain upon me. Wherever you are, you must get your portion. God has salvation waiting for you. He has forgiveness waiting for you. He has eternal life waiting for you. Whosoever shall call on the name of the Lord shall be saved. Whosoever. Whosoever. You are the man. You are the woman. He wants to forgive your sin. You can raise up your hand and stand up. As you are standing up, quietly tell the Lord there, and say, Lord, I am sorry for my sin. Tell the Lord, I'm sorry for my wickedness. Tell the Lord, I'm sorry for my evil deed. Forgive me. I believe that Jesus died for me to take away my sin. And you said, whosoever will call upon the name of the Lord will be saved. I call upon you now. Save me, Lord. Save me, Lord. Save me, Lord. He's doing it right now. Raise up that hand, let me pray for you. Father, in Jesus' name, we thank you for your mercy. Thank you for your love. Thank you for the promise of salvation, that whosoever shall call on the name of the Lord shall be saved. All these who have stood up and they say they want your forgiveness, they want your salvation, save them in Jesus' name. Take their sins away. Give them eternal life. Confirm that salvation in their lives. Let the joy of salvation, the victory of salvation, and the grace of salvation come into every one of them right now. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. In Jesus' name we pray. And Niger State will give me a good amen. Your miracle is coming on your way. We'll stand up as we pray. Remember, whatever the problem may be, you need a miracle. You need healing. You need deliverance. Whatever, you are going to receive it right now. Give me Niger State power. Amen. You raise up your hand for your miracle. Then you lay the other hand on yourself. And you know that after the final amen, the rain would have fallen, you would have gotten your portion. Then you'll check up yourself. If you are blind before, you open your eyes and begin to see. You are lame, you rise up, you begin to walk. Anything is holding your body, everything will vanish away. And we're going to rejoice with you tonight. Another amen. Raise up that hand. Father, in Jesus' name, we come to glorify you. We come to appreciate you. We come to honor you. Because you are a God that cannot fail. You've done it before. You are going to do it again. You've given us the former rain. You are bringing the latter rain. Lord, I bring that rain of supernatural blessing upon everyone right here now, in Jesus' name. That demonic spirit, demonic power, evil spirit, I command you, come out in Jesus' name. Spirit of epilepsy, I command you, come out in Jesus' name. Every swelling in your body right there, I command that swelling to melt away in Jesus' name. Goiter, vanish away in Jesus' name. Hunchback, vanish away in Jesus' name. Anemia, vanish away in Jesus' name. That swelling of cancer, I command that cancer to be healed, and the swelling to come out, be healed in Jesus' name. That issue of blood, dry up in Jesus' name. HIV AIDS, be healed in Jesus' name. Cough, tuberculosis, be healed in Jesus' name. Any sickness, any pain inside your body, I command that the pain to vanish away. I command that sickness be healed in Jesus' name. Those who are deaf and dumb, I pray the Lord will touch your ears, will touch your vocal cords, begin to hear, begin to speak out in Jesus' name. Lord, I pray for those who are blind, touch their blind eyes now. I command that blindness, that glaucoma, that cataract, come out in Jesus' name. I pray for those who have one leg shorter than the other. I command that shortlet to grow out in Jesus' name.
ina umuri ne akan wadanda suke da kafar guda ya fi kafa guda tsawo wannan lokacin kafan ya zama
dai those are broken bones be healed in Jesus name
ko wanda bangare na kashi da ya karye na umurta ya koma daidai yanzu na
stroke paralysis be healed in Jesus name
shanyewan kafa ko wanda bangare ka warke yanzu na cikin sunan Yesu
Lord I pray for everyone everywhere now to the left, to the right, to the back, to the front, in the middle. Everyone, Lord, touch them, heal them, deliver them in Jesus' name. Confirm the miracle everywhere. Confirm the healing everywhere. Confirm deliverance everywhere. Thank you, Lord, because I know it is done. In Jesus' name I pray. Wonderful. You have got it. You are healed. You are delivered. You are set free. You check up yourself. Whatever you were not able to do before, you begin to do. We're going to shout and rejoice together.
Shake up. We are waiting to rejoice with you. Blind eyes, open your eyes. Shake up. We are waiting to rejoice. Just shout. Shout. Want to hear your shout of
hallelujah.
As you have received your miracles, and you are sure, work out, shake up, counselors, help them, and as they are there, help them to come out. We are here to rejoice with them, and we shall rejoice with you. Right from the back, in the middle, in the front, left, right, shake up. Bring them forward. After interview them, please. After interview them, just line them up. Let's testify. Can you come forward here? Others, come up.
Your name,
your full name, where you are coming from, whether you are from Mina or any other part of the state.
So nanka da inda kai hito ko da daga nan jahar Mina nan cikin birnin Mina kake ko kuma duk bangaren jahar Niger da
kake. We're waiting for people who are still gathering there.
Muna jira.
Lord, my name is Patience Zekwe. I come from Bida. I'm a teacher in St. John's School, Bida. So, by the special grace of God, I'm a child of God. The devil decided to strike me with diseases. So, I was taken to hospital. They diagnosed, they say I have diabetes. In addition to it, they say I have cancer in the breast. Not long, they say I have pneumonia. I was admitted in Federal Medical Center, Bida. To the glory of God, my husband come and request that they should discharge me today. I have to be here. The hospital said no, I'm on treatment. My husband told me that they cannot help him. He wants to go where he will get final solution. While I'm entering here, I cannot walk. So my husband hold me, but that the prayer was going on. Strength come inside me. God remembered me and healed me. I'm standing in the ground here to testify that the pneumonia, diabetes, and cancer has gone.
Amen.
May the name of the Lord be glorified.
Amen. You said you are carried here, you can't walk with your legs.
I can't walk. I told them at the gate I can't walk. My husband has to drive his mom. I manage, I come down. You see, I don't wear slippers. I cannot walk if I wear anything. He hold me in the hand and walk near. I wanted to lie down on the ground. There was a brother that gave me a chair. I sat down in the chair. As the prayer was going on, I received my healing. I started walking.
Amen. She said something. The husband said, she is going to where she is getting a final deliverance. And I declare you, we've gotten your final deliverance. Your final deliverance. Be running now. See her dancing. Why will she not dance? Why will she not dance? Final deliverance. Everybody say final. Another testifier. Your name.
Praise the Lord. Praise the living God. By the grace of God, my name is Sister Suzanne B. Amadu. I was once a chronic sinner.
From where are you coming from?
From Izom, under Suleja region. I was once a chronic sinner, not until when I gave my life to Christ. The boy that is standing beside me here is my sister's son. He's had problems since at birth. This is one leg and one hand. It was bent. Even the time we were coming, that is how he was drawing the leg. But to the glory of God, after the prayer of our daddy, the hand and the leg is now straight. Praise the Lord!
Praise the Lord! Now, Yamba, stretch the land. Let him stretch it. Can you see it? She said, this is how the arm was bent before. Stiff together. Now see him. See the wonder. Praise the Lord! The reproach is taken away. The reproach is taken away. She is going back. See the hand. Stick together. She can now slash it off. Praise the Lord. More testifier.
Sunanka da inda ka fito baba
Abdullah daga Cipada Lenda na jira bar cewa za mu zo nan gari sai mun ji cewa buguwa cewa ya koma baya to sai kwano kuma aka ce ya zo yau kuma na magana pastor na wanda mu cewa zai zo ni zai kokari zan mu gwada mu gani domin wannan ciwon zo shekara uku kenan alisa bai sauki ba kuma la kawo yau dan gama duwa lalle na ga canje me zai yi kare ba na ga canje domin na yi tafiya kadan da
su amen
na tashi daga can na zo nan ga shi har zo nan na gode Allah
amen
my brother da mun kada baba menene ainihin ciwo menene ainihin ciwo da
praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. My name is Akin Olorufemi. It's from my district. It's the village head of the village where I'm pastoring. So he has a problem of 3 years. My name is Akin Olorufemi.
What is the problem, please?
The problem is that she has been having leg problem for 3 years. She could not walk without this staff. She has invited me even into the palace. I've gone there to pray with him. The other time that the crusade is to hold, we invited him and he told me he's going to follow us, but they postponed it. And then when this one coming now, I decided to go and inform him that the crusade is going to hold. And then he decided to come. So I told him to just believe God, sat down in the front there. He said immediately when the prayer was going on, he felt something just upon him, and then he left the stick and stood up and he do what he couldn't do before. He even trip from that place without the stick to this place now. That's
praise
all we come to.
Praise the Lord. This is not a young, this is not a small boy. This is an old man, an elder, a chief. She came here, he came here with a walking stick. Today, tonight, is walking back as a free man. Is walking back as a free man. The Lord will keep his healing for him. Everybody say, praise the Lord. Can you see our papa as he's walking down majestically? Praise the Lord. Just be patient. You will hear greater testimony.
Praise God. Praise the living Jesus. I by name, Adebayo Cornelius Benga. All along from Mekupele. I came to this. My age, I'm 49 years old. I came to this crusade this evening with crawling. I'm having stroke since last year. That is 1 year, 2 months now. I just managed to come. And this evening, when our papa is saying that we should be touching all the elements area in our body, I put my right hand at my head and this my hand at my knee. I hold it. As after he said amen, we should shake, and I try to shake, and I can see that the stiffness is kakakaka, and I can jump.
Praise the Lord.
I can jump. I can hold my hand and I can shook it. I can bounce my hand and I can draw all my fingers. I can see my fingers is pointing.
Praise the Lord.
And I'm jumping. Praise God.
Hallelujah. My brother, that's your hand at a stick. Can you stretch it again? Can you hear him? He said he crawled into this place. He's now walking back with his leg. Is God not good? This kind God, I never see his kind, though. Somebody that crawl him is now going back. Everybody say, praise the Lord. The shame is rolled away. The reproach is rolled away. How happy he is. We are also grateful to God. Praise the Lord. You can go back with your blessing. It shall be permanent. Next testifier.
All the glory, we give you honor. We give you all the glory, we give you honor. Praise God, hallelujah. Praise God, amen. Praise God, hallelujah. Praise God, amen.
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 You people will be sorry to me, my English, because I didn't go even primary school.
Go ahead.
But what I will say, I thank God for everything. I thank God for what he does to my daughter. Because she was suffering with one boil for her neck, and that boil was bringing out water. And with God's grace, now I can see it. I told you there's not any boil there, and there's not any water coming out from her neck.
It is dry.
I say thank you, Jesus.
Amen.
Thank you, Daddy. Thank you for everything.
Can you see that?
God, I thank you.
Can you see that?
I thank you. Daddy.
She came with her daughter.
That's what the doctor.
With a ball. Flowing. With pulse.
Daddy,
water.
I thank you for everything.
Now,
I don't have much to talk, but I have to say, Daddy, I
gone.
Thank you for everything.
You know, the prayer was going. He said, vanish, everybody. The whole thing has vanished. I say it has vanished. The water dry up. This is God. This is the finger of God. Praise the Lord. Woman, go with your blessing. Keep the Lord will keep the blessing. Nothing will happen to your daughter again. Praise the Lord. Now the next testifier.
Mun gode Allah da abin da baban mu yayi mana da kuma Yesu. Mun gode Allah ya saka da alheri. Wannan mama na kasance da ita na je makaranta shekara daya. Ina makaranta aka kira na aka ce mama na ta yi paralyze na dawo gida. Bayan na dawo gida mun je wurin magani mun yi shekara daya ta ji sauki tana tafiya amma ba ta daga kafa sosai. Muna gida sai pastor na deeper life sai ga baban mu hanya yana tafiya sai yake ce mai akwai wani taro da za a yi Amina in za mu iya zuwa sai baban mu ya ce ba mu da kudi amma zai taimake mu da transport sai ya ce to ba damuwa mu je mu shirya mun shirya mun zo nan yanzu nan kashi baban mu yayi mana addu'a kashi mama na ta tashi tana tafiyan ta gode Allah.
Praise the Lord.
Now God has saved our lady.
Praise the Lord.
Then I beg a cup and tears.
Yeah, be Allah.
Don't go. Don't be patient with us. Yes.
We are going to kuna.
Need a kachani. Suna na Habiba. Suna tokuma Laraba.
Her name is Habiba. That's the daughter that spoke. And the mother's name is Laraba. They are from Kacha. And they had of, in fact, when she was at school, she was told that her mother was paralyzed. Totally paralyzed. So they heard that the general superintendent of the Deeper Life Bible Church was coming here, but it was postponed. Later on, they heard he was coming. So the father supported them to come here and gave them transport money. And as they came here, when the GS completed his prayers, she was shocked. She was rather surprised that her mother was perfectly healed.
And she can walk now.
And you can see her.
Let her walk back. Can you see?
Kungani?
Can you see? Can you see that? This is rain. God never discriminates. God never discriminates. Can you see rain for all? The rain is still falling. Next testifier.
Praise the Lord. My name is Marvelous from Kuzangura, Shiloh District. Since last September, on a particular Saturday, I found out that I could not breathe very well. And even if I want to breathe, my chest will be paining me. I told my mommy and she told me that I should not worry, that I should reject it. Since then, sometime, if I breathe, I find out that my chest will be paining me. Small time, I will breathe very well, and small time, I will be finding it hard to breathe. And sometimes, my sister will be asking me, why are you not breathing well? And I will tell her that she should leave me alone. She should leave me alone. But today, after our father and the Lord finished praying, I found out that I can preach well. Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
May I be your bangiji.